explorers, it's Justin again. We are here outside at a beautiful pond. Ponds contain fresh water, which means the water has very little salt in it. It may not look like it from far away, but there is so much life to see all around us here. So today, let's take a look around and discover what lives in fresh water. Welcome back. Thanks for joining us at the pond today. Like I said, this is fresh water, which means it has very little salt in it, unlike the ocean, which has a lot of salt. Today, we're just observing to see what plant and animal life lives here in the pond to help us decide what to film next for our documentary. You know, ponds contain fresh water, but other places do too. Can you think of other places where you might find fresh water? Take a moment to pause the video and record your ideas in your field notes. Rivers, lakes, and wetlands contain fresh water too. All of these places are called freshwater biomes. A biome is a community of plants and animals that live in the same area. So a freshwater biome is a community of plants and animals that all live in and around fresh water. Freshwater biomes, like this pond, are home to many different plants and animals. They're filled with life because they have everything needed for life to thrive. Do you remember what living things need? Pause here and take a moment to record some of your ideas. Yes! You might remember from a previous lesson that every living thing, like animals, plants, and even humans, need water to drink. Without it, we would be super thirsty and just couldn't survive. But most animals, including humans, can't process all the salt found in ocean water if they drank it. That's why we feel thirsty after eating a salty snack. So most living things need access to fresh water to live. That's part of why so many living things thrive in a freshwater biome. They have plenty of water to drink. Freshwater biomes like ponds also have the sunlight living things need. Plants use light to grow, while animals need sunlight to keep them warm. All of the plants that grow here and the variety of insects and animals ensure there are plenty of things for everyone to eat, which gives them the nutrients they need. There's lots of fresh air to breathe and space out here too. Now, let's look around and see what life we could find here. I think I found something. Mia, come get a close-up on this. Frogs are a very common animal that can be found in fresh water. Frogs are very important to freshwater biomes because they like to eat bugs, which keeps the insect population under control. Frogs also need fresh water, not just to drink, but to lay their eggs. The water protects their eggs and helps their tadpoles grow. Wow, have you ever wondered how frogs can just sit like that all day? Do they even have bones? Anyway, like I said, frogs love insects, and lots of them hang out around here, like this dragonfly. Dragonflies spend their early life as nymphs living in water, which is essential for them to grow. And look, here's a snail too. Snails aren't insects though, they're actually mollusks, like clams or squid. Snails, especially the ones in fresh water, need the water to keep their bodies moist and to help them move around. Actually, I wonder if those have bones. Now, let's see if we can get a look under the water. Ah, yes, I see fish. Lots of fish live in fresh water. They too have an important role to play. Catfish dig on the very bottom of the pond, creating homes for other creatures to live in. Sunfish eat, well, just about everything. Small plants, insects, and even other small fish. They really help keep their habitats from getting too crowded. Fish, like catfish and sunfish, live their entire lives in water. Freshwater provides them with food, a place to live, and a space to lay their eggs. Let's take a look around the water now. I see another type of animal. This one lives outside of the water, but they do spend a lot of time swimming in it. Ducks. Ducks help plants grow in different places. When they eat seeds and then travel to other parts of the pond, or even to different water bodies, they spread these seeds through their droppings. Ducks use freshwater ponds for food, finding things like small fish and aquatic plants. They also need fresh, calm water for resting and raising their ducklings. Wow. Looking around, I noticed there are also tons of plants living around this pond. You can see all of the tall grass behind me. There are also wildflowers that grow here, and these beautiful purple flowers and lily pads floating in the water. Cattails, or typha, are here too. Plants like cattails and lily pads thrive in fresh water because it has the nutrients they need. They also help keep the water clean by filtering out pollutants, things that make the water unsafe, and providing oxygen for aquatic life. Reeds are another tall plant you might see near fresh water. They help the biome by providing a nice place for birds to build their nests. Whew, we have seen so much today. I think we found enough life here, and we have a new question to explore. Next time, we'll take a look at more freshwater animals and find out which ones have bones and which ones don't. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey, hey.